Are you thinking about getting a financial advisor? In this video, I'm going to tell you why you may want to look specifically for a fiduciary financial advisor. And I have a bonus tip at the end where I will share one of the best places that you can go to find a good fiduciary financial advisor. You're probably asking, what in the world is a fiduciary and what has that got to do with your search for a financial advisor? Well, I used to play a lot of basketball. It's one of my favorite sports. And one time I was playing a pickup game. I took a shot, landed on someone else's foot and twisted my ankle really bad. And I went to the doctor and the doctor said, Alvin, you need to get an x-ray. And I needed to get some crutches afterwards. And she told me, you need to go to a physical therapy session, Alvin, for it to completely heal. So when I was hearing that advice from my doctor, I wasn't sitting there wondering, is she recommending me to get an x-ray and the PT sessions because she's gonna get a kickback from those sessions? Or is she gonna sell me crutches where she's gonna get a commission? No, I'm not thinking about that because I trust that my doctor is giving me those advice because she wants me to get well. She wants my ankle to heal so I can walk again. My doctor is a fiduciary and I know that she is acting in my best interest. So that's what a fiduciary is. Someone who has sworn an oath to act in your best interest. You're looking for an advisor because you want to maximize your money. You want to make smart financial decisions and you want to just achieve financial freedom, right? So let me share you the three reasons why you should choose a fiduciary financial advisor. First reason is a fiduciary financial advisor will act in your best interest, just like your doctor. So a fiduciary financial advisor will want to help you maximize your money, will want to help you make smart financial decisions, will want you to achieve financial freedom. Your goals become the advisor's goals, as long as they're good for you. Second reason, a fiduciary financial advisor avoids conflicts of interest. So let me give you an example. So let's say your advisor tells you, I think based on your situation, you should probably refinance your student loan. So most likely, if you're working with a fiduciary financial advisor, it's probably because your student loan interest is maybe high interest rate, and maybe you're not eligible for public service loan forgiveness. And maybe your advisor thinks you can get a lower rate if you refinance your student loan and thus lower your monthly payment or maybe pay it off faster. So your fiduciary financial advisor is not giving you that advice because he or she is gonna get some kind of commission from that student loan refinance deal. Let me give you another example. So let's say your advisor tells you, based on your three goals of wanting to buy a house, wanting to travel frequently, domestic or abroad, and you would also like to start saving for your child's college, your advisor tells you, let's say you can afford to buy a $700,000 house without derailing your other two goals. So most likely if you're working for a fiduciary financial advisor, she's telling you that because she's crunched the numbers and this is gonna be what's best for you. And you can be sure that the advisor is not gonna get a commission from that $700,000 house purchase. Third reason why you may wanna choose a fiduciary financial advisor is because a fiduciary financial advisor is not tied to a specific company. What does that mean? Well, she or he can look at the entire marketplace and choose what are the best financial products out there for you. So let's say your advisor might say, I think we should probably open your IRA at this financial institution because you can get access to zero fee funds there. And while we're doing that, you should probably open a high yield savings account in this other financial institution because they give consistently high rates. And you should probably open a 529 account in this place because you can get a state tax deduction if you contribute and you have access to good low-fee funds in that 529 plan. So it just gives you, allows you the opportunity to work with someone who has a wide array of solutions. They're not tied to a specific company and can choose the best financial product out there for you. And this is the last thing. I'd like to give you a sense of what a non-fiduciary financial advisor look like, which, by the way, is a huge majority of financial planners out there. So you really need to be careful. So simply put, a non-fiduciary advisor is not required to act in your best interest. So think about that for a moment. A non-fiduciary advisor is not required to act in your best interest. How crazy is that? So let's say your advisor works for a big box firm and he tells you, hey, I think you should invest in this mutual fund. It did really well last year. And what if you knew that he actually gets a bonus for recommending you or once you actually invest in that fund? That's so not cool, right? And in fact, many large brokerage firms give an incentive to their advisor for steering clients into their own proprietary funds or products. If you're really into statistics and numbers, there is actually a 2014 report that was produced by the White House Council of Economic Advisors, and the report revealed that this conflicted advice, all these hidden kickbacks and fees, is costing middle class and working families $17 billion a year. $17 billion a year. That's money going from your neighbor, your friend, your coworker, all going to Main Street. So which would you rather work with? A non-fiduciary advisor who is not required to act in your best interest, or and who may be getting some type of incentive for steering you towards a particular product, or a fiduciary financial advisor who is out there looking out for you, acting in your best interest? I promised to give you a bonus tip, so here it is. If I've convinced you to look for a fiduciary financial advisor, where is the best place to look for one? My recommendation is you go to NAPFA.org. Look nowhere else. Just go to NAPFA.org. It stands for the National Association of Personal Financial Advisors. And once you go to the website, you just type in your zip code and several firms in your area, several fiduciary financial advisor companies are gonna pop up. District Capital Management is a proud member of NAPFA and will be happy to help you out if you so choose to work with a fiduciary financial advisor. Now, if you've managed to find a couple of prospective advisors and you have a Zoom call with them sometime the next few weeks, what do you think are the questions that you will want to ask to find the best fit, the best fiduciary financial advisor out there? Check out our video on four questions to ask a potential financial advisor.